But again, this is another essential for anatomy. These resources have just made it so fun, so much more enjoyable. I'm just doing it so much better. This book really has been a lifesaver this term, and it's just prevented a lot of tears to make sure you get the top marks in your exams. Really, I don't know what I was doing without it. Loves and welcome back to my channel. So today's video has been a long time in the making. I'm sure you've all heard me bang on about how much I hated and struggled with anatomy when I first started medical school. However, that has all changed and I would almost say I'm now loving anatomy. I've established so many tips and tricks that I can't wait to share with you that have just made the world of difference to how I study anatomy, and I think they're going to help you out so much too. Now, if you do like the sound of today's video, please remember to give it a big thumbs up. And also, if you have any more ideas on how to study anatomy that work for you that I don't mention in this video, then definitely pop them in the comments box below. I would love to help as many people out as possible, because anatomy is so personal, and that goes for all of these tricks. You need to find one that suits you. Practice it, see if it works. If it doesn't work, try another one. And that is exactly what I've done. But these are 8 of my favorite resources that are gonna help you out so much and boost your grades in anatomy. So my first resource is an anatomy colouring book. Now, this is the Netler's anatomy colouring book, and I actually used to use the big anatomy colouring book before, and this was definitely a great one to start with, and I really did make the most out of it. However, I just think Netler's is so much better. The diagrams themselves are so much more similar to what you're going to see in your anatomy exams, and they're also just a lot less detailed. There is less colouring in to do, and you also don't colour in the words, which I started to find really annoying in the big colouring book. I used to spend ages colouring and not actually learning that much, whereas this book is just really clear, really precise. It hasn't got as much information in as the other one. However, I would not use this to learn the information. This is just to help with your memory, to learn the names of the words, the muscles, or whatever you are learning, before you move on to some of the other ideas that I'm going to mention on later on in the video. This leads me on to my next resource, which is actually Ken Hubs. And I absolutely love Ken Hubs as an all-round anatomy resource. Ken Hubs have so kindly sponsored today's video, and I'm so excited to talk to you about this platform. Ken Hubs has articles, quizzes, videos. There really are so many different techniques of learning, and this is where I love to go and get my anatomy information from. I really like their articles, which actually break down everything so clearly, as well as using their images to make flashcards from. I really find the images and diagrams that they include are the perfect level of detail without being overly complicated, and really, really clear to follow. And not only do they have anatomy atlases, they also have medical images and histology, which were two sections I was really struggling with anatomy last term and do seem to crop up a lot. It's the perfect way of practicing to make sure you really can hit those top grades in anatomy. Medical imaging not only is important for exams, but obviously it is so important and so relevant for when we do become doctors. So I love that they have a whole section on this that is so easy to follow, so digestible, and you can also quiz yourself on it. The quizzes are one of my favorite features on Ken Hubs, as you are testing yourself and using active recall, which again I bang on and on and on about, but it really is so important for learning, especially in a topic like anatomy when there is just so much. You need to make sure you keep testing yourself to make sure you really understand the knowledge and also get it into your long-term memory so that you can actually pass these exams. Ken Hubs really has saved me so much time sifting through so many different resources, and it is also just laid out in tables and really easy to follow text and diagrams, and it's just made the learning of anatomy so much more fun and enjoyable. And if you do want to give it a try, they have so kindly offered all my subscribers 10% off if you use the link in the description box below to give you access to the premium membership and really make the most out of Ken Hubs and all the amazing resources they have to offer. My third favorite resource is still here, and that is Gray's Student's Anatomy book. Now, this is what all medical schools probably recommend for you. However, as you can see, it is an absolutely huge book and is slightly overwhelming. However, the one thing I cannot replace out of this book is the really clear, amazing diagrams. I absolutely love these. They really do resemble what you are going to get in your exams, and they are used as the reference for the amount of information you do need to learn for medical school. And this is probably why they are still Bible, and it is still a very important book to check. Although I don't tend to use it to get the information, because I feel it is laid out in a really unstudent friendly way, and they're just much better resources to find your information on than this book, which I feel like you could spend so much time sifting through your information and just spending hours and hours and hours on. I do still absolutely love the diagrams to just double check that I understand everything, and also make sure I haven't missed out any little details that could be important to make sure you get the top marks in your exams. Now, the final two resources that I love to find my information on are, first of all, Tamra's Notes. This is a new one to my edition, but I've not stopped putting this down this term. If there is ever anything that I'm really unsure on, I go straight to this book. Tamra wrote this for students, and she was a student herself who struggled with anatomy, and it's just written in such a user-friendly way. There are times where sometimes I do learn a topic and still feel like crying about it and that I don't really understand it, and that is where this comes in. Just before I start crying, I go over to this book, and most likely it's going to help so much. It's just really, really simple to follow, really easy, and it breaks everything down exactly what you need. This book really has been a lifesaver this term, and it's just prevented a lot of tears. It's very clear, and I also love the fact it is an actual book, because my second resource that I do always still go back to for information is, of course, Teach Me Anatomy. If you are a medical student, you've probably heard of Teach Me Anatomy, and I do absolutely love this resource. They have really basic, really easy diagrams. You cannot get information that is more easy to follow. The only thing I do have a bit of a qualm with Teach Me Anatomy is sometimes it is slightly wrong. If you always make sure to cross-check different resources as well as use your lectures, then you're going to be absolutely fine. And it is such an amazing resource for students that just has everything that you need to know. So the next few resources that I use are more for the revising and making notes. And first of all, that is, of course, Anki. As an anatomy lecture comes up, I will write my Anki flashcards as I go along. These will be a mixture between the basics, the closed cards, and the image inclusion cards. There is going to be a much more detailed on how I use anatomy for medical school video coming very soon. So make sure that you are subscribed so you don't miss out on this. The biggest difference for anatomy is the image inclusion cards. These are amazing because you can just make sure that you are properly testing yourselves. Anki has a built-in algorithm that makes sure the right cards keep coming up based on your understanding and how hard you found them. Doing a little bit of anatomy every single day is how I've been doing it this term, and reviewing my flashcards. I really do think the only way to approach anatomy is doing a little bit and often, else there is so much. Now, my next favourite resource is actually Complete Anatomy, and this comes on iPads or laptops, and it is basically a 3D human atlas, which means that you can put on all of the parts of the bodies. You can put on the nerves, the arteries, the respiratory system, the digestive system, and properly look at each part. You can even cut it up, you can isolate it, you can see the paths of different nerves. There isn't much that this app doesn't do, and really using this has also made the world of difference. I wasn't using this last term, and I didn't actually realize that we got it free as a medical school, and a lot of medical schools do get a free 3D atlas. So before you go out and buy it, just double check that your medical school doesn't have a license for free, because I know they are quite expensive. But again, this is another essential for anatomy, and really I don't know what I was doing without it. I think I was just doing anatomy all wrong last term. These resources have just made it so fun, it's so much more enjoyable. I'm just doing it so much better, and I'm not surprised I was struggling last term without these, to be honest with you. I am definitely a visual learner. I enjoy seeing anatomy. I think it's a very visual topic, and this means that in your exam, no matter what diagram you get, or whether you have it in a real cadaver, or whether you have it as a medical image, you have a proper understanding of what it looks like, and you haven't just learned it off a 2D diagram, which I think makes so much difference. And And this whole app just makes anatomy so much more interesting. It brings it off the paper. Now, the next resource I'm going to talk about is actually Ackland's video of anatomy. Now, this again comes through with my medical school and comes through with a lot of medical schools. But again, this has been so important and actually really testing my understanding. This guy explains things so simply and breaks everything down, and he also looks at it on a real cadaver. Now, my exams actually really threw me last time because we did actually have it from a real cadaver and a real specimen, and we haven't been able to go in very much at all to our prosection room, and this has really helped me out this time. Instead of having to feel like I've missed out, I've been able to watch his videos, and he's explained things so much better than I would have been able to do in the prosection room. So this is probably better than going in every day to the prosection. He goes into the perfect amount of detail without completely overwhelming you. His classes really break down every single step and go through it to really make sure you've got a good understanding on a different diagram. Finally, no list of resources for anatomy would be complete without Gray's Anatomy flashcards. Medical students absolutely love these, and I really didn't get it when I first ordered them. I ordered these before medical school, looked inside and saw how many thousands of cards there were. I only have half in here because I'm currently learning the other half. These shocked me and scared me, and once you get over it, I promise you, they are so helpful. You don't need to know all of them, you just need to get out the ones that are relevant for you. And what I've been really enjoying is doing a card a week, and just when I'm walking around the kitchen, when I'm watching television, when I've just got a spare minute, I just pop over and read this, and I promise you, it really adds up. They don't label the diagrams, the information is actually all on the back, which means again, you're using active recall and actually testing whether or not you know these cards and not just reading off a diagram, which is very similar to Anki, but it's just another way to mix up your revision and make sure that you're not letting anatomy get boring or dull. So those are all the resources I've been using this term. Like I said, all of them have made such a huge difference on how I'm finding anatomy, how I'm coping with it, and me actually enjoying anatomy, which I never thought I would say. I found it so overwhelming to start with, and it can be such a huge shock when you first start medical school. So just make sure you have a little try of all of these. There's no point sticking with a resource that you hate and that isn't helping your understanding when there are so many others out there. Let me know what you try and which resources are your favorite. And if you do want to try Ken Hubs, then make sure you use that discount code, which will give you 10% off a premium membership. And I will see you all next week in my next video, everyone. Have an amazing week. Bye.